Good evening. Thank you for tuning in and joining us for the final recital from the concert series, Something Different, Blacks in Classical Music. I am your host, Nerva Altino. First, let me express my thanks to you for your support and having enjoyed, hopefully, and watched these series from Russell Paul to the Soprano Twins. Tonight's program and final recital features myself, along with my brother Robinson, at the piano. The repertoire featured in this program is taken from the late Romanticism composers, from Liszt to Balakirev, as well as American composer Gershwin, his famous tune, I Got Rhythm. And we close out the program with a civil rights song. Our arrangement of it, We Shall Overcome. During this time, during this pandemic, many creative artists have had to find ways to share their talents with you. I admit I was a bit apprehensive about doing so in this forum, on this forum. However, we felt it to be necessary for Black History Month to share our gift of music with you. It is my hope and prayer that you will enjoy tonight's program. So sit back and relax as Robinson and I play for you. But before we begin, you're going to hear the Black National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing. Enjoy. Well, here we are, man. After a year of not having played any concerts, any recital, here we are. For the first time, we're doing a virtual recital. It's something that I didn't think I'd be doing because, you know, I enjoyed the performers who do this, but I personally didn't intend to do it. How do you feel about doing it?
Well, it is our responsibility.
Yeah.
God have not given us the talent to hide even during a pandemic.
Yeah, very true.
We still have to inspire young people as well as older people through music that God has given to us. So I feel good about it. Of course, I would prefer for it to be live, but that's where we are. Hopefully soon.
Yeah. There's nothing like a live audience, man.
Nothing.
Now, the people know that you're my younger brother, although you look older than I do.
No, I don't.
You know, but tell them a little about yourself, okay? So, you know, we could talk about the time that we used to fight to practice when we were kids. So tell them a little bit about those times, how we grew up in the household where Dad used to just play all day.
Well, I won't know those fights. Well, maybe not, but, well, we only had one piano.
Yeah,
we both wanted to be great pianists.
Yeah.
And that took a lot of hours.
It did.
Sometimes Dad himself would be on the piano. Of course, we couldn't fight with him.
Yeah.
But he would play his Mozart. And from that, we were inspired because at the time we were really just beginning piano. But the love grew. And the more we stayed in the field, the more the love continued to grow. In fact, I challenge anybody to study piano music, you will find it like we do, that your love for music, for piano, will always grow. And so we always had to be determined to improve. And so that's why we always used to fight. But then after a while, we had agreed that it would take 2 hours here, 2 hours there. And if we didn't do that, Mom would get on us. And so we had to follow Mom and Dad.
So now you're married, you have your own house and your child. So now you have your own piano. You don't have to worry about me fighting you no more for your practice time. So tell the people, how long do you practice per day?
Well, I do practice 4 to 5 hours a day. But I do have someone else that is fighting me for the piano now. And that is my son, Michael. Sometimes he wants to do everything that I do. Sometimes I have to tie him down literally. But I'm very blessed because I can always go upstairs to practice, but I do get 4 to 5 hours a day of practicing.
That's a lot of practice time, man. I think, and it shows in your playing, you know. So tell the people now, where have you performed? You know, we know that the Altino Brothers duo have done a whole lot, but where's some of the key venues that you performed, and what are some of the memories that you have of those venues?
Well, one of the greatest memories I have was Lincoln Center. 2002.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we made our debut. You played Prokofiev Third. Yeah, who could forget that? Yeah.
Yes, but not only that, but we did not realize that was Mom's last concert.
Yeah, who could forget that? She died later that year, just a few months after.
And that's right.
Yeah.
But she died happy seeing the concert, so that was amazing. And of course, in 2005, Avery Fisher Hall, Lincoln Center.
Yeah.
With the choir, our own choir.
Yeah,
you did the Beethoven
Fourth Fantasy. Yeah,
we had a lot of fun with that, trying to sing German.
and just imagine West Indian Caribbean people singing "Grosses Das in Herz der Grungen."
Exactly, it was just amazing, the Choral Fantasy, and to hear the choir. We had about 100 plus
voices, yeah.
And then, of course, Carnegie Hall.
Yeah, that was the big one, yeah.
You did the Tchaikovsky Concerto, I did the Litz.
I did the last movement of the Tchaikovsky, not the whole thing, but.
But that's all right. These are the greatest concerts that we have performed. But I must say, as great as these venues were, and as prestigious as they may be, there is nothing like playing for the Lord.
Yeah, absolutely.
And ministering to God's people wherever we may be, whether if it's Zoom, whether if it's one or two people.
Yeah.
You know, wherever God will take us.
Thank you. Thank you.
our work is done here. It is my hope and prayer that you've been inspired and blessed by tonight's program. Although we weren't able to feature any particular black composer, but the first piece as well as the last one were original arrangements of both my brother and myself. Before we close, I also want to thank the Linden Church, where this program is streamed from, where I have the pleasure of serving as music director under the leadership of Dr. Pastor Keith Alberry. And before I go, I just want to officially announce that for the past couple of years, I have been talking about a book that was going to be released, More Than a Gift. That book has been launched, officially launched now. That book is about a little boy who had aspirations to be a professional musician. He was born into dire poverty in Haiti. He is the son of a man who was once homeless. That little boy came to the United States at a young age, and he has faced many adversities. He went from bullying in elementary school, junior high school, then he turned to the streets in high school and beyond. But somehow his life was spared in spite of the adverse conditions that he continuously experienced throughout his life. And with God's grace, that little boy was able to achieve his dreams of becoming a professional musician. Well, that little boy is none other than yours truly. My life, my story that I have chosen to share with you. Please go out and purchase this book, More Than a Gift. It is my hope and prayer that you'll be inspired by it. You will experience a roller coaster emotionally upon reading it. However, I do believe that you'll be inspired by this book, More Than a Gift, My Life, My Story. Again, I want to thank you for tuning in with us. And to the music students out there, I want to encourage you to practice. And I look forward to seeing you in recital as well. Thank you again for joining us. Be blessed. Be inspired.